Casey, ladies and gentlemen, it's your girl Karen. I'm back with another one. All right, today we're gonna do a Q&A. Since I'm moving to college, I know a lot of people have a lot of questions, so we're gonna get into the video. Favorite thing about college? Well, I just got here, so it's not, I haven't done much yet, but the campus is quiet. You know, it's not, well, it's a lot to do. Like, it's a party going on tonight. There's a couple things going on tonight. So, basically, the only thing I did was move in and go to orientation. That's the only thing I did. So, I really don't have a favorite thing right now. And I went to go get my parking pass. I'd be long, long, long. How you like college so far? So far, it's really cool. It's really all right. My seatmates are real nice. We get along, we cool. We straight. The only thing I don't like about it is when we wanna come back to our room, sometimes we can't, which is like crazy. Sometimes we can't come back to our room because they want us out of our room. Like yesterday, we tried to come back to our room and They was not having it at all. They was like, oh, y'all gotta come back at 5 o'clock. Mind you, it was 2. So, how's life? Life is great, right? Life is good. Coming to college is a whole different environment. So, it's good. I'm good. We're good. Life is good. What inspires you to do makeup? What started me to do makeup is like when I was in 9th grade and I had to wear a full face for game days and nobody would help me at all. So I had, you know, I had to learn on my own. You have to fend for yourself. So that's what inspires me to, well, that's what started me doing makeup. But what inspires me doing makeup is seeing other people do makeup and influencer get bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger by the day. It's great. Cause it's like, I know this makeup artist that's from my hometown, local. It's like she grew. And I sit up there and watched her grow from, you know, when she started up until now. Now she a crayon cutie, a brand ambassador, got her own spot. Like she inspires me. Like she do that a lot, and I'm gonna put her page right here. But she's inspired me. She one of the people that inspire me. Beats by Deb inspired me, of course. Super inspires me. A lot of people inspires me to do it, but I don't be having time to do it. But I'm gonna try to start back doing it because I know y'all want these tutorials. Do you want kids in the future? If so, how many? The most I would want is 4 in the future. 4. If I have twins when I first have children, then I don't want any more. I don't want any more because that's what I really want. I just want twins. That's all I want. I just want twins. And if I get twins, then I'm closing that book. What are you majoring in? I'm majoring in business management. And I'm thinking about minoring in family consumers and service. That's basically child development. Since I already got my certification in child development, I'm trying to get my associates. So I don't know if I'm going to do a dual degree or just stick with my business management. I really don't know. But we're going to see. How tall are you? I'm 5'4". That's not short. Well, it is short, but in my book, it's not short. But I'm 5'4". What keeps you motivated? What keeps me motivated is seeing the people around me do their best. Seeing the people around me grow. That's what keeps me motivated. My family keeps me motivated. My friends keep me motivated. A lot of stuff keep me motivated to do more and want more for life. That's what keeps me motivated. What made you want to start a business? I'm the type of person that who love to do a lot of stuff. I'm very talented at doing stuff. I'm very crafty. So that's what made me want to start a business, because I could do a lot. And you know, when you can do a lot, you can make a lot. And it takes money to make money. So putting money into a business, you're gonna get it back probably double. Sorry, we're watching P-Valley, but you know, that's besides the point. Yeah, starting a business, what made me want to start a business is because I see a lot of people have businesses, and when I started the business, I want to start a business way before the pandemic happened. And then what made me want to really do it is the pandemic, because would not have been a perfect time to start a business than other than the pandemic, you know. And it's okay to make a lot of extra money. And I do makeup, shirts. I can put paintings on canvases. I can put a wig on if you ask me. I just go to other people to do my hair. I can do braids, singles, you know. I can do a lot of stuff, but it's just, yeah. I have a lot going on. I do have a lot going on. So, I can do whatever you want. Get at me. What do you like most about having your own business? Having my own business, what do I like most about it? Being self-employed. That's what I like most about it. Having my own business is, like, personally taking care of your own. That's like your baby. So, you take care of it, your own business. And, what I like most about my business is I don't have to clock in on nobody else's clock. I don't have to get on nobody, go and clock in on nobody else's clock. I'm on my own time and on my own business. I get paid. It's, yeah. And I'm good at it. So, and the aftermath of all my products, when I see it, it'd be amazing. Because it's like I just made this and I didn't know I can make it. Like, sometimes I be making stuff and I don't be knowing if I can do it or not, but I still make it. But I still try to make it, cause you know, you learn more by the day. So yeah. Okay, y'all, I got some more questions, so I'm going to answer them. First question, well, two is a question and one is a statement. Advice for high school students. Okay, let me start off with the freshmen. Y'all go check on y'all class rank. That is important. Make sure y'all grades are up there. Everything starts freshman year. You can't just think you're gonna be top 10 if you ain't doing the work freshman year and putting in all the work. You gotta start freshman year. Everything start freshman year. That's how your rank go up, stuff like that. And join stuff. Sophomores. I really didn't have a sophomore year, but I could just say, do y'all work, go to class, don't be skipping like that. Juniors, be involved. Just be involved in school and so all I can say is be involved in school. Cause if you don't be involved in school, school is boring. You just think about it. You go to school for 8 hours and listen to teachers talk. And then you don't have no excitement after school. So do something so you can go, don't have to go home after school. Cause like, that's just boring. Like, you, like I said, you sit there and listen to them talk all day long and then you just go home. Well, you could just be doing something fun at the school. See, me, I was in activities like SGA, all them different clubs. I was in that. And I had fun after school. I did. I was in band doing auxiliaries. Some days was hard. Most days was, you know, fun. It was just my senior year. I had to get up out of it. Anyways, seniors, it is your last year. So make every assignment, everything you do, count. You don't have time to be fighting. You don't have time to be arguing. You don't have time to be wasting time. Because your senior year goes by really fast. And I wish I could do my senior year over. Because, honestly, my senior year was the best year. Out of all my years. Even though I had a lot of work to do. But they're just preparing you for college. Because in college, you're going to have a lot of work to do. And you're going to have to get it done. So, in my opinion, seniors, now is the time for y'all to, now is the time for y'all to get ready. It's time for y'all to buckle down and handle your own responsibilities. Can't nobody do your work for you. You gotta do it yourself. And cheating don't always work, cause sometimes cheating gets you a grade you don't want. So you don't gotta cheat all the time. But cheating do get you past a little bit. So that's what I got. This is my advice for high school students. Are you judgmental? I'm not judgmental. I'm not. Cause I don't have no room to judge nobody. Cause nobody's perfect. So, of course, I'm not judgmental. Like, what? How I'm gonna judge you? And I got problems going on myself. Can't judge nobody. Can't judge a book by its cover, right? And this statement said, "I love you. I love y'all too." I don't know if y'all can see it, but this is my old phone. Don't do too much. Don't do too much. I'm recording on my new phone. But say, "I love you. I love y'all too." All right. That's the end of this video, and I love you guys, and have a blessed one. Have a good day.